British payments on agenda as Barnier demands end to ambiguity. K. Stavis counters that EU must show more imagination. Follow at Brexit for all the latest news, and sign up to our daily Brexit Bulletin newsletter. European Commission President Jean-Claude Juncker lashed out at the UK's Brexit position documents after British negotiators revealed a growing exasperation at what they see as the European Union's stubbornness. "I've read all the position papers produced by Her Majesty's government and none of them is satisfactory," Juncker said on Tuesday at a conference in Brussels, shortly before talks between the UK and the EU resume. "There is still an enormous amount of issues that remain to be settled." The stage had already been set for an intense round of negotiations after the EU's chief negotiator, Michel Barnier, and Brexit Secretary David Davis met on Monday for the first time since mid-July and candidly aired their frustration at each other's approaches. Read more about why the divorce bill is holding up Brexit talks. The UK has published 11 documents outlining its positions in areas that need to be settled as part of its withdrawal from the EU, ranging from data protection to nuclear safety and customs arrangements. While the UK hoped the papers would persuade the EU to deal with their future relationship at the same time as the most pressing separation issues, European diplomats criticised the documents for being unrealistic and failing to nail down what exactly the UK was asking for. A plea for the EU to show flexibility and hurry talks along was immediately snubbed by Barnier, who accused Britain of a lack of clarity. The UK camp believes negotiations could progress if Barnier's team didn't follow its mandate to the letter. "Constructive negotiations. We must start negotiating seriously. We need UK papers that are clear in order to have constructive negotiations," Barnier told reporters as he stood alongside Davis before their meeting on Monday. "The sooner we remove the ambiguity, the sooner we will be able to be in a position to discuss the future relationship and a transitional period. With 8 weeks to go until a key EU summit at which the bloc's leaders will be asked to judge whether the negotiations have made sufficient progress to allow the UK to open trade discussions, the talks have made little headway on Britain's financial settlement and plans for the Irish border. Officials will try to tackle both on Tuesday. There's growing impatience in Brussels. For the moment it seems that UK decision-makers are busy arguing at home," said Carsten Nicol, Deputy Director of Research at INEO Intelligence. "If the papers question the agreed sequencing, then what we're actually seeing is a rolling back of progress achieved. Stumbling block. The UK's bill remains the biggest stumbling block to an agreement, with Davis determined not to tell the EU where it accepts it has obligations. This month he told the BBC that this was part of his negotiators' constructive ambiguity approach to try to obtain a better deal. Standing with Barnier, Davis told reporters that the week ahead is about driving forward the technical discussions across all the issues. "But in order to do that, we'll require flexibility and imagination from both sides." The UK doesn't appear to have given up on exploiting potential rifts between the European Commission and the countries that give it its mandate. Davis at one point said some of the EU's 27 government backed his demands. Earlier on Monday, the French presidency denied a report in the Daily Telegraph that it was willing to take a softer stance on when trade talks could begin. Neither the UK nor the EU is expecting much of a breakthrough this week, even as both British and German business lobbies came together Monday to call for clarity and certainty. Davis will leave to his colleagues the task of making progress on how to keep the Irish border open after Brexit, the status of citizens living in each other's countries, and the infamous bill. Without progress in these three areas, the EU is adamant that talks cannot move on to commerce. Pressure for a breakthrough has increased since the Labour Party, which came close to unseating UK Prime Minister Theresa May in June's election, announced it wants a four-year transition arrangement to avoid a cliff edge. That is a tempting proposition for anti-Brexit Conservatives, who could shift allegiances and force May, who lost her majority in Parliament, to make concessions she otherwise would have resisted, with assistance by Emma Ross Thomas, Emma Charlton, Rainer Bergen, Robert Hutton, Victoria Dendrenu, and Jones Hayden.